Well, you just got done with some traveling, right? Where all did you go?
So I just went a couple weeks ago to Washington, D.C. for the NFA, and we had a chance to meet with 17 different congressional offices on safety, on just introducing, Steve was introducing me as the new president, talking about with some CPSC things, like with the new e-filing comments that were made. And then we also got to have lunch with Meta, which was huge for us. And so obviously it's a problem, right? And I kind of had told our lobbyist, hey, if we're out here, is there any way you can get us a meeting with them? And so he was trying. And 48 hours before we left, we found out we were going to get to have lunch with two representatives from Meta. So we put together a presentation with them and collected safety information for them. Like, here's the different categories of fireworks. This is how we're restricted. This, you know, we went through all of that. Like, hey, how can we help our members and the fireworks industry be able to just use your platform, use the Meta platform? Because there's so many people in Facebook restrictions, or what we kind of call Facebook jail. And so we definitely have gotten our foot in the door with a lot of that. So that's good.
That, I just got to say, that is huge that you guys were able to do that. Thank you so much for like lobbying on behalf of the fireworks industry, especially business owners who are trying to just, you know, post and, like you said, use the platform, Facebook especially, just to get their business out there. And Facebook is like, okay, you can't talk about fireworks. You're going to be banned from doing any like group activity for 48 hours or things like that. It's happened to my personal profile. It's happened to so many others in the business. Mm-hmm. So that's huge. If we can get, I don't know how quickly those changes will be made, if they will be made, but it's huge that you were able to represent the industry in that way and kind of bring it to their attention. So that's, I just want to say thank you for doing that.
You're welcome. It's definitely a need for, you know, everybody really in the industry, whether you're a mom and pop, whether you just have a tent. Now, you know, their policies did change in December, which is why we're seeing a lot more of it now. So you definitely want to go through and appeal everything as long as you're doing everything according to their new policies. So definitely, if you're a brick and mortar, make sure you have different rules. You get to do a little bit more as long as you're not selling fireworks on their, or explosives on their platform. And so definitely look at policy and appeal as long as you're, you know, within their guidelines.
Yeah. And still, we can't like pay to advertise anything related to fireworks anyway, pretty much on any platform, but Facebook especially. So it's all just like organic posting. So the ability to do that. So you're saying just go ahead and appeal it if something comes up, because
yeah, as long as you're, you know, yeah, because some of it is within their standards, but you know, their AI technology is already seeing the word fireworks or in your business, and you're already going to just, they don't think it meets their community standards. So you just need to go back and make sure that, especially if you're a brick and mortar and you can't do it on your personal page, you need to make sure that you have a brick and mortar Facebook like page, and everything has to be shared through there. And so definitely look at the policy. I know that NFA just put it in their newsletter and on our Facebook, you know, but we kind of just disclose to them, if you put, we know people in our industry that have been put on restrictions for 30 days. If that happens June 1st, we can't even get our safety message out. Yeah. And so, you know, we kind of brought that up to them, and they, you know, we're not really aware of that with our industry. So they're kind of, we've got our foot in the door with them. They're apt to listen to us. And so right now, you know, this is the policy, but they do obviously change policies. So just kind of that back and forth. Hey, here's who we are. We don't, you know, we don't want to be a threat to your community. So,
right. Well, that's fantastic progress. Just hearing that it's been brought to their attention and that there's ways around it. And hopefully it will potentially be a little bit easier to make those posts and to protect yourself and your account on Meta's platform. So that's incredible.